Oh my God! Oh, I just saw the best film of the year. It's The King's Speech. I ran up here as fast as I could. And now I'm talking to Geoffrey Rush, an Academy Award winner. This is a great honor to meet you, sir. And what
Thank you.
A brilliant performance.
That's a great reaction because...
Thank you. Well, that's how I feel.
Somebody said to me yesterday, you know, when I read the blurb and before I'd seen the film, I thought this is going to be a slightly dry experience and it probably will fit into a certain genre of the backstage royal British drama or whatever. And they then saw the film and said it was moving, it was entertaining, but you did it better.
Oh, well, I mean, it wasn't a dry experience. It was a very wet experience because people were crying in that last scene. And oh my God, Geoffrey, is it Sir Geoffrey or is it just Geoffrey?
It's just Geoffrey.
Because after the movie, I thought maybe you'd been knighted too or something.
No.
I don't know how that works with
They don't allow that in my country.
Oh, they don't allow it. Well, we're at the Toronto Film Festival. So Canada, of course, you know, it was just, the audience, they went wild. They were applauding. It was very, very exciting.
Oh,
and you're going to the Oscars again, young man. This is an Academy Award performance. Maybe you'll win. The second one.
I don't know.
If I say it, they usually do it. So.
The great thrill. We're still in that very exciting period where the film literally made its debut last Saturday at Telluride. And Tom Hooper, as
director,
had finally done his last tweak last Tuesday.
Oh, my God.
Took the film under his arm on the plane, arrived in Telluride, screened it.
And the crowd went
And
wild.
we knew when in making it and in all through our collaboration, even in post-production, directors don't normally let actors give them notes.
Oh, no, they
But he
don't.
Was always sending us copies of the current cut saying any advice, any thoughts, and like extremely generous and collaborative. And we all love the story because the idea, of, you know, dramatically, it's a bit of a gift to have this imperial figure and this nobody colonial across this cultural and class abyss, as history tells us, merged in the most unlikely way into a mutually respective friendship.
This is a historical fact. And do you want to tell our viewers what your character is? I was so surprised and delighted.
Well, when I first read it, I mean, I knew the big parts of the history about the abdication of Edward VIII, but I had no idea. I did know that Bertie had a stammer and that was a very debilitating part of his, you know, reluctance, you know, to not want to be king.
And you're this
But I had no idea
teacher.
About Lionel Logue, had never heard of him. And the fact that he was a failed Shakespearean actor, and I thought, well, there's a semi-autobiographical dimension.
But you did that scene so well, Geoffrey. I loved your Richard III.
I was intrigued by that, you know. I loved thinking about him. I don't know what the international cultural stereotype is of what an Australian is. And I got very intrigued by the personality of this guy, having been someone who studied elocution and Shakespeare back in the 1920s, who happened to also be a self-developed speech therapist because of his vocal abilities. He was the guy who, a bit like Rivers in the First World War in England, developed these fairly challenging speech pathology techniques because of the shell shock victims coming back from the front in the First World War.
The script just sort of came to you in the mail and...
it was on my front doorstep. A neighbor who was a friend of the woman who wanted to produce it as a stage play in London left it in a brown paper package on my front doormat. And I thought, well, that's okay. And I read it and I went, wow, I can't do the play. It's too much time at the moment and I had other commitments.
This was a play originally?
Yeah, I think, well, I don't know, for David Seidler, it may have started out as a screenplay, but then he adapted it as a play, thinking I'll probably get it on more easily if it's in a theatrical form, I don't know. But I certainly, in reading it, thought this would make a pretty fascinating screen story because the A plot of the big history you could treat in one way, but the B plot of the therapeutic sessions, I mean, they just cried out for close-up work.
Yes, it's very intimate,
where the actors could find the richest inner life for these two unpredictable characters.
And what was it working with Colin Firth?
We basically picked up from, I'd worked with him very briefly on Shakespeare in Love, but during the press junket in New York, we would hang out and we clicked. Colin is...
This film reminds me of Shakespeare
in Love. One of the most delightful, hilarious social companions you can be with. And once we knew we were working on this together, we just picked up on that press junket mentality that we had 12 years ago.
And here we are again, carrying it on. And I saw you on Broadway and you won a Tony, didn't you?
I did.
For that wonderful performance
It was Exit the King.
Exit the King, another
an obscure thing. Yeah, exactly. This is my King period.
I'm in my Queen period, but it's lasted an awful long time. Geoffrey Rush, thank you so much. What a great honor, and I'll see you at the Oscars.
Thanks.